Hi everybody, I'm Kirsty Meekin from Naio Nails. In this video, we are going to show Nancy how to do dual forms using the topits, and then she is going to do one on herself for the very first time. Let's get started. So what I need to do is I need to take down the length of this nail. We're going to put a tip on. So you'll see in some of my videos, I have used topits with a tip and without a tip. I think they are better with a tip because they make life a little bit easier. And we all want an easy life. So I was pushing back those cuticles, and then we're going to remove the surface shine from this nail. That's going to stop the product from lifting. So we've removed the surface shine. That's going to stop the product from lifting. I'm going to wipe over with, not that, with this. I'm going to wipe over the nail with gel residue wipe off solution. That's going to clean the nail up. We do have a video all about tips and how to fit tips and the different kinds of tips and what they're used for. So if you love tips and you want to know a little bit more about them, you can check that video out. I'm sure that Adam will link it somewhere on the screen or in the description box somewhere. By magic. I'm now going to cut down the length. I'm going to make sure the side walls are nice and straight. Also, filing this little side to make sure that that tip's not bulking out. We don't want to add any thickness. I'm going to roll the tip between my fingers and thumb. And that's going to make the tip have a better C curve. It's going to make it a little bit stronger as well. I'm just going to lightly go over the tip just to blend it slightly. File free edge. Then I'm going to wipe over with pure acetone. And what that will do, it will slightly melt the tip. And that's going to blend it in. So it will all be blended into the nail. And now I'm going to size up the dual form. And this is really important, this stage is, to get the size correct. We need to make sure it fits from side to side. And we also need to make sure there is enough room in this side, this little capsule, to hold the product. So you don't want to really press it down like this. You need to just place it on nice and gently and check that it fits from side to side. So now I'm gonna go up a size and see how that fits. So that's a 6, we're gonna try a 5. And we're gonna go with the 5. Don't forget to prep the nail with your prep product, so we're going to dehydrate. So first we're going to dehydrate. Nancy's taking all of this in, just like a sponge, soaking up all the information, aren't you? Then we're going to use the acid-free primer just on the natural nail. So when you place this on, you need it to fit nice and snug around the cuticle area. That's the first thing that you're going to do. I'm using Tawny Rose. This colour is beautiful, absolutely beautiful, and fits perfect to Nancy's skin tone. It's gorgeous. It's brand new as well. do get excited when I get new things. In the topit, we're going to put the product. So we're going to pick up bead. I'm going to get rid of that bit. And I'm going to pull it to the edge, nice and thin. Nice and thin, Nancy, yeah?
Yes.
Make sure we've got enough for the length. You can always pop it in the side of the finger to check that you've got enough product in there. You're always better having too much product than not enough. When you put this onto the nail, we need to make sure it's wet. So we're going to get a wet brush and we're going to rub it over the top and just sweep that to rehydrate the acrylic. So we're going to start here, right at the cuticle. This is very important to get this part right first of all. And we're gently going to rock down onto the tip. I'm going to hold it in position. Any excess that you have, scoop that away either with the end of your brush, or you can use your cuticle knife. So you can always get rid of anything that comes out.
Do you think there's been enough close-ups of your fingerprints to be able to like frame you for a marker?
Probably. Once that starts to set, and you'll feel it getting warm, you can okay, maybe we're not ready.
Maybe he's not pop it off.
Maybe not pop it off just yet. Just like that. Ta-da! So once it's set, you're just going to literally rock it, holding these little tabs here. You're just going to rock it like that till it comes loose. And then all we'll need to do is give this a bit of a file. Same filing routine. So I'm going to do my side walls, get them nice and straight. I'm going to gently go around the cuticle. There isn't a great deal of filing that needs to be done, to be honest with you. Your free edge nice and straight. Then I'm going to buff over with the block. This sort of double checks that everything's nice and smooth, and also it'll cause slight abrasions, which will help the top coat stick on. So if you put the top coat straight onto that shiny surface, it may start to lift off the top coat, may. So I just want this to be a little bit abrased so it's not so shiny. We want it nice and smooth, we just don't want it shiny. Then we're going to wipe over with acetone just to remove any of the excess dust, and it'll smooth the nail. Then we're going to apply the Urban Graffiti top coat. You can also use Mega Gloss as well. And wham bam, thank you ma'am, we have a nail. Pop that in the lamp. Lovely jubbly. So So it's not too thick, it's not too thin, it's going to be nice and strong. Quite easy to do. Are you ready, Nancy?
Yes, I am.
Come on then, let's do it.
And we're back in the room.
We're back in the room. Look up for me, Nancy. Look up at the camera. Look at the camera. She's flapping, man. She's flapping. She's a right flapper, let me tell you. She's like, have I got everything? I'm like,
she's not like you who has to have everything round her all at the same time.
Yeah, I need like a donut table so I can have all the products around me. Yeah, I'd love that. Can someone make me a donut table for my nail products? Yeah, so we're back, and Nancy is going to have a go now. Nancy's never done this before. So, yeah, see how it goes.
Let's go.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So, you're going to prep the nail first and push the cuticles back and all that. Take the length down. Tell you what, she's a good listener. She does take it on it. So I think the most difficult thing about this will be making sure the product's wet and making sure you don't press too hard when you rock it on. Having a soft, gentle press and not actually moving it. So when you rock it on, you don't want to slide it. You've got to go. Some people go, and move it. So with the tip, what we've done is we've cut the little ears off at the top so it fits the nail a little bit better. Sometimes with the well-less tips, because they've got such a beautiful deep smile line and that contact area can be a little bit high when you're gluing it onto a nail that's quite small, because we know that Nancy has small fingers. So she's going to cut the length down. And then she will file up the side walls, get everything nice and neat. Beautiful. So we're going to size up the dual form, so this topit needs to fit from side to side. That's nice there. What's the other side? I have a check for you. So this is an easy way to do it as well. If you hold it in position at the cuticle and then you loop down, you can see it fits from side to side, can't you?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So you need dehydrate and all that. Really nervous for you. I'm like holding my breath already.
Why?
I don't know. I'm like nervous sighted. I'm excited and nervous at the same time. So a gentle press. Mm-hmm. Oh, I feel like I can't look.
Why?
So drag it nice and thin to the cuticle. Brilliant. Right, now get your next bead. And you want to make sure you get right to those sides as well.
Mm-hmm.
Unlike I did, I was had to go back and have a little, miss the side of it. You want to make sure it's long enough for the nail that you're going to create.
I'm holding my breath.
I know, it's like... I on the other side. She can do it. And I just put a little bit here.
Here we are.
Yeah. At those corners. Because it's a square nail, isn't it? So take it into the corner.
That.
Yeah. And pull, 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 and then re-wet your brush.
We need a little.
She's such a fan here. She keeps fannying about. I'll add a bit more. Slap on more. A little bit more. Just a little bit there. A little bit there. Perfectionist. It's not bad. Are you ready?
There. Mm-hmm.
Let's
I'm
do
ready.
It. Okay. So turn it over. You gotta be quick because it's gonna dry. That's it. So right at the cuticle, nice and neat. Pressure, make sure you keep most of the pressure here and rock it down. That's it. And then if you can put your finger on the top and sort of look at the end of it to see if you've got enough. And then you want to press a little bit further down here. So that's it. Good press. Here, yeah?
Yeah.
Keep pressing further down. So it'll squish it a little bit more.
So, it's with the tip, you can push the tip underneath as well, can't you? Like clamp them together a bit.
Yeah. Like that. See what I mean? You've just got a bit missing there and there on each side. But you can add to that. I've done that in a video, haven't I? Mm-hmm. And add it to it. So just hold it now while it sets.
Hold it,
just hold it up, yeah. So pinch it and rock it.
Pinch it and rock it.
So you're prising it off. So imagine you've got a plastic nail stuck on, you know, them ones that used to stick on, and you want to pop it off.
That way.
So now try to do it right. Try to lift this now. Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
So lift it from that corner, that's it. So lift it, and again, there you are.
Voila!
Voila!
Oh! I did it!
Do you know what? That's pretty good for your first go, isn't it? That is pretty good for your first go.
That's better than I could do.
Do you know what?
Yep.
It is. All we need to do is just add a little bit of acrylic down that side there,
mm-hmm.
and a little bit there, which you can do that, no drama. Go on, get that done. How did you find it? How did you find it easy or hard? Or
This is easier than using the form.
Yeah,
using the
a
tip.
Normal form.
Mm-hmm.
It's easier than tipping overlay.
Yeah.
It's good for if you've got clients that want just a full extension with gel polish on top,
mm-hmm.
but like they we were saying before, you know, you can put glitter in it and everything, you know, you can play about
this,
with it.
We can put glitters on this, yeah,
can,
the way you've put yours, yeah?
Yeah, you can put glitter acrylic into that.
Okay.
So we're just going to finish with cuticle oil. Well, I think she's done a fantastic job. It's brilliant. Beautiful. You pleased?
Of course I am. I'm so excited.
Ooh, well done. Well done.
I did it.
Yeah.
There.
Say, if Nancy can do it and she doesn't even do nails, she's never tried it before. If Nancy can do it, you can do it. Keep watching. Don't forget to check us out on Facebook and Instagram. All the products we've used today will be listed below, as always. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Adam, put your hand next to Nancy's. Let's just have a look. How small they really are.
Can I just make sure, have you got a nail brush?
Really?
A nail brush, yeah, because I've been cleaning today. I was hoovering and washing and all sorts before you guys got here.
Okay.
Luke, this is Nancy's hand. And that's Adam's big hand. Nancy has tiny, tiny hands. I think she's a child, really.